Okay, good morning everyone. Again we are starting with our part 3 of accounting equation. Okay, again I am telling you we are following T.S. Grewal and page number 5.6. In the first two parts I have already covered the basic as well as some one illustration question. Now we are moving to our illustration question number 2nd. Illustration number 2nd. Again, I am telling you here the format of accounting equation, serial number will be there, transactions are there, asset is equal to liability plus capital. Okay, so here, first of all, what we have already written the transaction, started business with cash. Started, you will find it on your page number 5.6, started business with cash. So, someone business, who is the guy, nobody has given. Somebody has started the business with cash of 70,000. Okay, so here what are the first we have to analyze the, which two things are impacting. One is cash and one is starting his business, then capital. If somebody is starting business, then what with cash? The cash is involved and capital is involved. Capital is a liability, cash is a asset. Okay, so it is only for the understanding. Here, I will write the cash and capital already written here. So, you need to write again. So, how much cash? 70,000. How much capital? 70,000. Liability, no liability is there. Okay. So this is our first transaction. Moving to the second. Second transaction is credit purchase of goods, rupees 18,000. So here we will write credit purchase of goods. How much? 18,000 rupees we have purchased. Again, here we have to find the two things. Here credit purchase. Credit purchase means udhar purchase. So which two things are happening here? Two variables are involved. Credit purchase. That means credit kisse purchase kiya hoga? Creditor se. So one, creditor will be involved and second, what they did, purchase kiya to, what will be happen, stock will increase, so stock will increase and creditor is also increased because we have to pay the amount to the creditor for the purchase, so both the things will increase, stock is a asset, creditor is our liability, so we have to write it. Stock, liability on liability side, creditors. Okay, so stock is increasing by how much amount? 70,000? No, 18,000. So we have to increase. Cash is increasing? No. Stock is increasing with 18,000. Creditor is increasing with something amount, yeah, 18,000. Okay. Capital is increasing, no. So here's the new equation. Here we have to write new equation. What is the new equation? Cash 70,000, stock 18,000, creditor 18,000 and capital 70,000. Got it? Now, third transaction is given to is payment made to creditor in full settlement. Payment made to creditor in full settlement. So we have to write it. Payment made to creditor in full settlement. Okay, so now we are making payment to creditor in full settlement. So what does it full settlement means? Full settlement means nothing is now left. जो भी पेमेंट करना था हमने कर दिया, अब कुछ लेना देना नहीं बचा है. That is termed by full settlement. So what two things are involved here? Again, creditor payment किसको किया? Creditor, so creditor is involved. And payment made for what? Payment किया है, then what is happening? Cash is given. So cash will be involved, है ना? Payment made to creditors and cash will be involved. Okay, remember this term. So how much payment we have did? We have payment of 17,500. So cash will reduce of 17,500 because we have did payment to creditor, and creditor will also decrease by how much? 17,500. Okay. Stock is impacting? No. Capital is impacting? No. So here our new accounting equation will be made. 70,000 minus 17,500. How much it comes? $18,000 minus $17,500. How much it comes? Okay. Up 18,000, 1,500. Here 70,000. If you will total them, first of all we have to write here. New equation. New equation is over. Let's see whether their asset is equal to liability plus capital or not. So here 70,000 plus 15,000, 1,500. How much is come? 71,500. Here 18,000 plus 52,500. How much it will total? 70,500. So the both are balancing. That means this is forming an accounting equation. Okay, our last transaction. Now, here the fourth transaction is purchase of machinery for cash. So here we will write purchase of machinery for cash. This is my fourth and last transaction of this illustration. Here also two things involved. One is cash and second we are purchasing machinery. So machinery is fixed asset and cash is our asset. So here we are purchasing machinery, so in our company the machinery is increasing and cash is decreasing. So cash is decreasing, then what we do? How much cash we have given for purchasing? 20,000. So minus 20,000. From the cash, and machinery is increasing. Here I will write machinery. Okay, so how much machinery we have purchased? 20,000 rupees. Is equal to the same other creditor is increasing? Sorry, 18,000 have written. Stock is impacted? No. Creditor is impacted? No. Capital is impacted? No. So now the new equation. This is only for the understanding, so I am rubbing them. Now, new equation. How much? 52,000 minus 52,500. How much it comes? 32,500. 18,000 plus 20,000. Is equal to creditor 1,500, capital 70,000. So again we will see whether they are balancing or not. So here 71,500. Here also if you will total, how much it comes? If you total 71,500 come, that means asset is equal to liability plus capital. Account equation is formed. Do it in a fair copy and practice it well so that you can understand. These things are new for you. Moving to next question.